Hello everyone. In this video, we will discuss perquisites exempted for all employees. Free medical facilities. This has already been discussed in my previous video. Refreshment, tea, snacks provided by employer to employees during office or factory hours at workplace, except free meals. Free meals served to employees working at remote areas or offshore installations are fully exempt. Free recreational facilities provided to employees by the employer. Expenses incurred on telephone or mobile phone given to employees for facilitating employer's business is also fully exempt. Employer's contribution to staff group insurance scheme is fully exempt. Free education provided to employees, family members up to value of rupees 1000 per month per child is fully exempt. Over and above shall be taxable. The employer provides such benefit from his or her own resources in which he or she is engaged in such business. If the employer bears a fee or cost of expenditure of employee incurred and pressure courses or management courses or higher education in India or abroad attended by employee, such expenses are treated as scholarship and are fully exempt. These courses are for the employees to perform his or her official duties efficiently. Any scholarship paid by employer to the children of employee is also fully exempt. Tax paid on the value of work by employer is fully exempt. Conveyance facilities provided to employees free of cost by employer for reaching workplace and going back. Conveyance facilities to judges of Supreme Court or High Court, these are also fully exempt. Amount contributed by employer towards pension or deferred annuity scheme, this is fully exempt. Rent-free accommodation provided to an officer of parliament or union minister or leader of opposition in parliament is also fully exempt. Perks allowed by Government of India to government employees who are Indian citizens who are also posted abroad for enduring their services. These are fully exempt, but this exemption is not available to non-government employees and those who are not citizens of India. Computer, laptops given to the employees for official or personal use, this is fully exempt. Any second-hand or pre-use movable asset like computer, laptop, car, refrigerator, or other electronic items transferred to employee without adequate consideration and such asset had been transferred by employer after using for more than 10 years will be fully exempted. This is very important point. Often this has been asked in the question. Concessional loan or interest-free loan is given to employee is fully exempt, but if that amount of loan does not exceed rupees 20,000 during the previous year. In case such loan is taken for the treatment of notified diseases like AIDS, cancer, mental disorder, renal failure, hemophilia, thalassemia, and no claim is received by employee from the insurance company, only then it will be fully exempt. But if the insurance claim is received, such amount shall be treated as a loan. Difference between interest rate charged by the employer and the rate of interest fixed by State Bank of India shall be taxable. In case loan is taken for other purpose and rate of interest is equal to or higher than the rate of interest prescribed by State Bank of India, then it is fully exempt. Periodicals or journals required for discharging work, goods sold to employees by employer at concessional rate, the amount of concession given shall be fully exempt. That's all. Thank you very much. Take care. Bye-bye.